Welcome to my first video of my new channel, Retire a Millionaire Starting at 35. Now, if you took high school economics, you may know that the benefit of starting as young as possible on your retirement savings or just investing in general or anything that yields a return, the earlier the better. But you know what? A lot of people don't get their start in their teens, like is the ideal. A lot of people don't even get their start in their 20s or even at 30. Let's say you're 35. I hope you're not too worried because, yes, you too can retire a millionaire starting at 35 if you just do okay. I'm not talking about getting rich or like having a few hundred thousand dollars a year at a job. I'm saying and making millions off of real estate investments. I'm talking about just doing okay, making a lower middle class income of like 40, I'd say 40,000 plus benefits or two incomes, earning 40,000, I would call lower middle class at this point in time. There are still some numbers that consider that like one person earning 40,000 a year to be a middle class household, but I think with inflation, which is mostly in like fuel, groceries, and real estate, I'd say that's where that hits the hardest. Technology, of course, has gone way down in price. But how do you retire a millionaire starting at age 35? Well, first of all, step one, the maximum contribution to a Roth IRA is now $6,000 and will likely increase. Now, unfortunately, the Roth IRA calculators online, I can probably show you this. This is bankrate.com. Don't want to show you too much. They only go up to 5,500. They were not updated at the beginning of this year. But let's say you're 35 years old, and you start putting away $6,000 a year. Now that's a little over $100 a week. So if you get a measly 8%, which is what the S&P has returned since it was adjusted in the 1950s, you'd have $702,000. Now, that's not quite a million, but there's another part that I'm going to tell you about. And that's just for the basic model. You can actually do much better still only doing middle class, not even being upper middle class or rich. So getting just 8%, you're doing really well. Now, if you get 10%, which is what the S&P has returned on average since it was formed, we're going even further than their 50s. They changed a few things in the 50s. You'd have a cool $1 million. And if you got 12%, which would be a good return of, you know, somebody who's skilled, who isn't charging a fee, should be able to manage that. I'm going to make another video about how you can return more than average without taking high risks. And of course, if you are a really skilled trader, unfortunately, the Roth IRA calculator will not let me go up to 20%. And based on these first three, it appears to be a roughly 50% increase. So I went with a 50% increase roughly each time. So if you made 14%, you'd make at least 2.25 million. 16%, at least 3.3 million. 18%, more, at least 5 million. And 20%, at least 7.5 million. It might be much more, but remember, you only have 30 years to work with. And of course, this is based on $5,500 a year, with nothing before age 35. So that's really amazing. Now, step three, your house. At 35, you should be in a secure enough position that you can buy a house. Now, I should have put this in the title, but the title was long enough as it was. Retire a millionaire by age 65, starting at 35. Well, a 30-year mortgage fits perfectly into that spot. If you have a middle-class income and you do not currently have enough saved to buy your own house, move back in with your parents, save, get that house. And then, instead of paying rent so some guy can make money off you, you now are paying a mortgage, so in 30 years, you will have your very own home. Now, I don't consider real estate the best investment, in my opinion, but if you're paying rent, you might as well be paying a mortgage of the same amount or less. If you're paying less, the difference might be enough to fund this. Step one. Now, you might be wondering, how can I retire even richer? Well, let's start with step four, and that's your 401k. Now, employers will often match 50 to 100% for anywhere from 3 to 6% of your income, and that's where they usually cap it. You can put up to, it's either $18,000 or $27,000 a year away in a 401k. I would say if you have enough money that you're able to comfortably do that, I would say don't take any risks. Put it in the S&P 500 low-cost index fund like Vanguard, and consider during, you know, once a bull market is established, consider some safe speculations in your Roth IRA to try to get those big wins. However, in a good year, the S&P might go up 20 to 40%. And if you look at a chart of the annual performance, in the good years, it's up 10, 20, even 40%. And in the bad years, it might go down 50% for like a year. You might see a few years where it's down 50 to 30 or 40%. You know, each, you know, some, it won't be more than one that's down 50% most likely. But anyways, now if you really are a great trader, you may be able to say, okay, it's time to get out of the market and get into cash or get into, you know, some liquid investment that returns 5%, like a very high grade bond or something like that, and ride out what you predict may be a storm. Now, you might be wrong, and then you lose those gains that you would have made. But if you're right, and I believe that it's easier to say, okay, you know, at some point in the next year, we're going to have a major crash. If you're wrong, you lose, let's say, 20%. If you're right, you gain 50% by not losing it. And when you reinvest at a lower price, you're getting possibly twice as much shares, twice as many shares. So now here's step six, your spouse. If you marry somebody who also has a career, then the two of you combined can do all of this stuff, and you'll wind up with multiple millions or even five, maybe 10 million. All this without taking significant risks from 35. Now, again, simply going with S&P 500, 5,500 a year, that's just over $100 a week, at 8% can yield $702,000. And if you simply buy a house, in 30 years' time, it should be worth at least $300,000, and that's very conservative. Those two things combined equate to $1 million. And there's real estate benefits on your house, so any gains that you make, you can offset those, or you may, you know, the first quarter million gains, if you live there for 2 out of 5 years, can be tax-free, and you can also do tax-free rollovers. But also, that Roth IRA, it grows tax-free. And is you can take it out without paying any taxes. And that 401k grows tax-free, and you don't have to take it out all at once. So that is this week's episode of How to Retire a Millionaire, starting it at age 35, by the age of 65.